Permanent mandibular canine is the third tooth from the midline. Its tooth number in FDI system is 4-3 and 3-3. In universal system, it is 27 and 22. And in zygmondipalmar system, it is 3 with appropriate quadrant brackets. The word canine is derived from the Latin word canis. Moreover, it is also called corner tooth and cuspid. The function of mandibular canine is tearing. The tooth develops from four developmental lobes, mesial, labial, distal, and lingual. Together with maxillary canine, it helps in guiding the jaw to close in correct position, called canine guidance. In the jaw, it is the last tooth standing, as it fights two main diseases of teeth, caries by its self-cleansing property and loss of anchorage by having a long root. The chronology of the tooth, age of eruption of mandibular canine is 9 to 10 years. Coming to its dimensions, the cervico-incisal length of the crown is 11 mm and root length is 16 mm. The mesiodistal diameter of the crown is 7 mm and at cervix it is 5.5 mm. The labiolingual diameter of the crown is 7.5 mm and at cervix it is 7 mm. The curvature of cervical line on mesial side is 2.5 mm and on distal side it is 1 mm. The morphology of the crown is studied under 5 aspects. Let us start with the labial aspect. The outline form of the crown is trapezoidal with its longer side towards the cusp and the shorter side towards the cervical line. The cusp tip lies on the midline axis of the tooth. Among the two cuspal slopes running from the cusp, the distal cuspal slope is longer than the mesial cuspal slope. Coming to the contact areas, the mesial contact area is in the incisal third and the distal contact area is in the middle third. The cervical line is convex with its convexity towards the root. The labial surface shows a labial ridge running from the cusp tip to the cervical line. A single root is present which is smooth and conical. Coming to the lingual aspect. As the lingual aspect is narrower than the labial aspect, all the features of the outline form from the labial aspect are same in the lingual aspect as well. Although, the crown surface is very different. Two cuspal ridges, mesial cuspal ridge running from the cusp tip to the mesial contact area and distal cuspal ridge running from the cusp tip to the distal contact area. Mesial marginal ridge running from the mesial contact area to the cingulum and distal marginal ridge running from the distal contact area to the cingulum. A lingual ridge running from the cusp tip to the cingulum. The cingulum is the circular convexity present in the cervical third. Between these ridges and cingulum are two shallow concavities called the lingual fossae. The root is smooth and conical. Next, the mesial aspect. The outline form of the crown is triangular or wedge-shaped with its base at the cervix. The cusp tip lies lingual to the midline axis of the tooth. The labial surface of the crown is convex with its crest of curvature at the level of the cingulum. On the other hand, the lingual outline is convex in the cervical third, concave in the middle third, and convex in the incisal third. The cervical line is convex and the convexity is towards the crown. The root is smooth and tapering. A depression runs along the root length called mesial developmental depression. Next, the distal aspect. All the features of the tooth from the mesial aspect are same in the distal aspect as well. Though, the distal developmental depression present on the root is deeper than the mesial developmental depression. Finally, the incisal aspect. As with all permanent teeth, no part of the root is visible from the incisal aspect. The labial outline is convex and the lingual outline shows lingual convergence. The cusp tip lies slightly lingual to the center.